There's still a lot of confusion, though, when it comes to the Omicron variant, such as do the vaccines keep you from getting the virus, or does it just really lower your risk of a severe case?
Yeah, and tonight's Medical Watch, Mick Farris got the answers to those questions, including when we might see this surge finally end.
Our first question is, are vaccines effective against Omicron?
The initial two doses, while they were effective against prior variants, appear to have greatly diminished effectiveness against Omicron, and it's really the booster dose which makes a big difference as far as reducing the likelihood of becoming ill and certainly seriously ill or hospitalized.
And the booster is most effective if you've gotten it recently.
It appears that after a short number of weeks, the immunity provided by the booster also begins to wane. So this suggests, to me at least, that we may be looking at further boosters moving forward.
These charts show it clearly. The unvaccinated is the top line, getting the most cases. The two-dose vaccinated, far fewer cases, and the boosted, even fewer, shown on that bottom line. And look at how protective the vaccine is against deaths. The two-dose and three-dose vaccinated are far below those unvaccinated. They are 10 times more likely to test positive and 20 times more likely to die from COVID-19. And new variants are much more likely to be created when the virus infects unvaccinated people.
The more time it replicates, that means there's a higher likelihood of there being additional mutations, because those mutations develop every time it replicates.
Now, when it comes to the infusion of those monoclonal antibodies to help you fight the infection, it appears only one brand helps with Omicron, and that is in short supply. So what is the prediction about when this Omicron surge could end?
The climb is going very quickly, and once it makes its way through the majority of people who might potentially be susceptible or exposed, then for a period of time at least, we won't have a reinfection.
Forecasts can be off, with human behavior hard to predict, but this surge could possibly decline in mid to late January, well before Mardi Gras parades roll. Meg Farris, Eyewitness News.
Now, some local doctors do think that Omicron could be around longer, in fact, longer by a couple of months, if a lot of unvaccinated people don't get it before we head into the carnival crowds.